back to another episode of Ask Firefox. Today's topic has been carefully selected by an algorithm. And that topic is... algorithms! First question. I feel like everything I watch online is suggested to me. How much are algorithms controlling what I see? So if you've taken advanced algebra in your life, you may remember the Euclidean algorithm used to find common divisors of positive... You should have seen the look on your faces. Advanced algebra? Psh! Could you imagine? The kind of algorithms we're talking about, while technically still mathematical in nature, are presented to the world in a very human way. They exist behind the scenes in services we know and love, like Twitter, TikTok, or Hulu. Think of algorithms as that one annoying coworker who loves to recommend you everything they love. Psst! Shanae, you absolutely have to look at this meme I found. You haven't watched Stranger Things yet? OMG, don't even look me in the face. You really need to see this Jimmy Fallon clip. While sometimes these suggestions can come off as annoying, they become an essential part of the internet experience, especially for platforms like YouTube. In 2018, YouTube reported that a whopping 70% of time spent watching videos were ones recommended to users. That's a pretty big chunk. But when you think about how much content there is swirling around in this big internet toilet, there has to be some way of digging through the noise. Take Twitter's average of 6,000 tweets per second. If every one of those was in your feed, then you'd never get to see my banger tweets. This has created a unique and fickle ecosystem across the internet. Instead of all videos being pushed by the YouTube algorithm for the merit of their content, they're being pushed based on globally accumulated data from all users and directed to you based on just a few key data points and world events. Next question, how is Instagram getting my information? Do they read my text? Algorithms in social media and video streaming can definitely give off some creepy vibes, recommending you content that can be eerily personal or outright strange. However, it's important to know that most of these algorithms can really only use what they've been fed. In fact, some algorithms, like YouTube's for instance, create a suggestion profile for you based on just three factors: voluntary data, observed data, and inferred data. Voluntary data is data that you would offer up to these services on your own volition. An example of this would be subscribing to your favorite educational tech YouTube channel. Not to name any names, but... By subscribing to a channel like ours, you're essentially saying to YouTube, I like the following content: technology, education, and dope hair. Yeah, 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 yeah. YouTube adds this information to your profile and uses it as a metric, sort of like digital biscuits that you'd feed to a dog that looks like the Terminator. Next, algorithms gather data through observing how you're interacting with content. Let's use Twitter as an example. You're scrolling through your feed when an ad for cheese-flavored toothpaste pops up, and the combination of fear and intrigue causes you to slow your scroll. Twitter has just taken note of the brief stop you made to look at this product, and you may start to see more of it in the near future. Using the data gathered voluntarily and through observation, the algorithm infers new data, making educated guesses based on what it already knows about you. This is where we may start to see some of that weirdness being injected into your timeline. However, your interactions matter, and if you're strategic, you can learn to tame the algorithm to your liking. Most algorithms used in social media and video streaming platforms are backed by some form of AI, which allows them to grow and change as more data is collected. Some people love the convenience that comes with this system, while others prefer a little more privacy. Having a little pupperino who brings me all sorts of internet goodies to try sounds great, right? Don't forget, there's a Terminator living inside that dog. Let's go to our next question. If the algorithm knows so much about me, why do I keep being served things I don't like? Algorithms are primarily influenced by your actions on the internet. However, they are controlled by the platform, which can lead to suggestions that aren't necessarily brought about by your actions. This can lead to some serious issues, like forcing opinions onto users they may not necessarily agree with. This process is often referred to as tilting the floor, and it involves recommending content to users that puts them on a guided path towards one specific topic. This is especially dangerous when you introduce politics. The morality of an algorithm is not determined by the user, but rather by the owner. Unfortunately, many companies that control social media algorithms prioritize their revenue over knowing what they're pushing to your screen. To them, it's all about increasing engagement, regardless of the content. It could be hate speech, misinformation, or God forbid, cheese-flavored toothpaste. The data collected by algorithms can also be used maliciously and sold to advertisers or used as a means to steal other information from a user. Services like TikTok have a highly invasive approach to gathering your data, which is why it sometimes feels like you're being stalked. However, some algorithms are trying to make a difference. Mozilla, for example, recommends using what is known as a lean data approach to only gather the bare minimum amount of information, as each byte of information on a person increases the potential risks. Tell us about some of the weird suggestions you've gotten from algorithms in the comments below. So there you have it, algorithms. Want to know more? Hit us up on IG and Twitter. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for new videos every week. Bye-bye!